Oh, I'm just starting it off with a drink now. First, it's an iced tea I'm drinking, guys. And so, today it is Saturday, May 7th. It is almost 8:30. Because today, I was being a crazy nut today, and I was off at 5:30. And I was just waiting around for Matthew because I want to go home and then make the pizzas fresh. And I got the pizzas here. These are homemade pizzas. This one is a seafood pizza with crab meat, ham, and pineapple, and bacon bits, and cheese. And this one is the chicken, pineapple, bacon bits, and ham. And it's got tomato sauce on it. And for the seafood one, originally I wanted to do it with the white sauce, but I did not have money to buy the separate white sauce, so I'm just going to be sticking to it with tomato sauce, so sorry about that. Those people, that has to be proper. And yeah. And also this dough, I am so grateful that I discovered this dough at the grocery store because it's very convenient to use. They sell it in bags in the ball. You can either buy it frozen or thawed if you wanted to use it right away the day. And this dough works so much better than that Pillsbury stuff. I just love crab meat, guys. Crab meat. I can just eat it like candy. I can just eat it right out of the pack, from the package, raw, like candy. I like have to slap myself to stop. I don't know from where you guys are from, but I don't know if you guys know what crab meat is. It's this type of pollock. They call it Alaskan pollock or whatever. It's this like pinkish stuff here. It looks like this pinkish stuff. I don't know if every country around the world has that. But the one thing that annoys me is that Walmart used to have this packaging. I used to buy it all the time. It's like a two-pack, and it's like one price you pay for a two-pack. And it's a really, really good deal. But now... bacon bits. They kept the same brand, the same price, and then they just sell it as a single pack now. Such a rip-off. Pizza, pizza party. Yummy pizza. Like, I don't know, like, you know, like, the haters are gonna hate, but, like, gonna blah, blah, blah. It's, like, not totally homemade or whatever. But at least this is not the frozen pizzas from a package. It's like we used our own brain to figure out what toppings to put on it. Like, look at how loaded these pizzas are. Oh my gosh, like look at this. Like, I think if we worked at a pizza restaurant, I think they're gonna fire us in the first day. Because we're gonna put way too much toppings on it. And also, if you guys notice, I changed a different shirt. So ever since I got this shirt from Zazzle, this has gone through like two or three washes already. And I think it still looks okay. And of course, this fancy stuff, you want to wash it inside out. And no, I haven't set up the Zazzle store yet. I am still being very lazy. Sorry about that. Because after my holiday time, the stuff has gone back to the routine. This seafood creation pizza is so good. So once again, it's got the crab meat, the ham, pineapple, and bacon. And cheese. You know, like if I had also more money at my normal grocery store, they now sell like a regular item. They sell the poutine cheese, like the Canadian cheese curd for the poutine. I would have so loved to put the poutine cheese on the pizza. But at home, we do have the regular cheese, so that would do for now. So how are you guys' weekend doing today? Because right now it is the Mother's Day weekend. I know the British people has a different Mother's Day on a different day. Because I watched Steve from Steve Vlogs and they have Mother's Day on a different day. But like I said, for my mom, because neither of my parents work, so they can celebrate anything, anytime. There's no rush to it. You know this pineapple? I think I always buy the wrong one because I bought the one on the tin, it says the pineapple chunks. I think I should buy the pineapple tidbits, which would be better, because this is like, makes it looks like a monster pizza on the pineapple. That you guys should seriously try to make your own pizza, guys. Like for almost 2 years now that we discovered this pizza dough, me and Matthew has actually bought way, 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 way less frozen pizza. And actually at the moment in our freezer, we have no frozen pizza at all. And the frozen pizza is a normal thing in the North American freezer. But because we got used to this type of pizza, making it ourselves, we actually like it better this way, way more. Because we could just use our brain a little bit and just think of what toppings to put. And also, besides the pineapple, I bought the can of the pineapple. The toppings, it actually came from our grocery store's salad station. I just picked up the stuff because I'm just too lazy to dice up my ham and too lazy to cook up the chicken and stuff like that. Because their salad station, they go by the weight anyway, so they don't really have any rules what you can put or not put in there. It's not like they got a salad station policeman watching you guys when you get your salads, but they do have people watching, like the ones that put it in and eat it before they pay. They do have people watching for that though. There is a few people ruining it for everybody else. Right, guys? And so today, my work was just so busy. Busy like Christmas. It was like lined up like Christmas today. And then it's like so funny, like my work participates in raising funds for the Red Cross, and they post a sign there that you can option to donate to Red Cross, and you can go get the tax form, which is the proper way to do it. And it's not like I get commission or anything to advertise it. The sign is there. And it's not like something you have to force on everybody that wants to or not want to, because if you sometimes talk about it too much, people will like bitch at you about it. You just can't win sometimes. And some people was like, why didn't you tell me about this donation? I said, hello, the sign is right there. It's like, why should I be advertising that for the Alberta fires when I don't get paid commission for it or anything? Like, we're not supposed to get paid commission for that. And some people are just so weird. You just cannot please everybody. Pizza. So what are you guys' favorite pizza toppings? Mine is usually quite random. It's whatever I feel like. When I was originally wanting this pizza, I was originally wanting Matthew to split the dough and to make mini pizza of each flavor, but Matthew forgot to do that. And Oh, and today, when I was waiting for Matthew, I also hang out at the McDonald's nearby today. And I saw the weirdest thing ever at McDonald's. I don't know if they do that in all of the McDonald's now. But now in the McDonald's, they have those, the create your own burger thing. And then you can choose your sauces, the toppings, and whatever. And so I was like people watching as usual. And so apparently, when you order the create your own burger thing, and when you choose to eat in, they actually serve it in a special plate, and they got like a cute, they got a cute little basket to serve the fries in, and I so want to buy the basket. I hope they're gonna sell that as a gear. Like, the basket is shaped like the French fry thing where they fry up the French fries. And then they actually have a person to serve it to your table, which I thought was pretty weird. But apparently, you have to pay for each additional topping. Like the burger starts at a set price. So I know a girl that used to work at McDonald's, and she says it's not really worth it. And then in my opinion, it's like, Subway is the same idea, and so if I want to choose my own toppings, I'd rather go to Subway. Do you guys have to create your own burger thing wherever you guys are? Because I know that McDonald's everywhere have a different stuffs. So, yeah. Oh, and once again, about the Alberta fires, be careful of the scammers asking for donations because there are scammers out there. So in my opinion, the safest place to donate to would be Red Cross. The Red Cross will not try to cheat us, I guess, I hope. And once again, the Red Cross, if you donate to Red Cross, the federal government will match you the funds, the Canadian government. So yeah, it's some crazy fires though. Scary. Oh, and also, in my yesterday's vlog, I talked about having a white sangria for the first time, and I really, really want to try to make the white sangria at home, because I really, really love it. It was really good. I tried it at the dinner theater last week. So if you guys have any sangria recipe ideas, please let me know in the comments below. So maybe when I get paid this Friday, I'm going to try to make a sangria. Like for me though, I never like to have the straight up red wine or white, the red wine or the white wine. Because that's just the way I am, because in my house, when I was growing up with my parents, I was never really raised up in the culture for alcohol and stuff. My mom did not allow any alcohol in the house. So I was never really around that stuff or influenced by alcohol. Like back then, if my dad wanted to hang out with his friends, he would need to go to his friend's house or to the bar. My mom just never allowed alcohol in the house, that's all. But for me, I do like the odd cocktail or two. So yeah. I don't know if it's something with the warm weather we are having right now or something, because this weather is making my brain feel very fried. Oh, I'm getting full. Because I had coffee before I came home. Later, when I have too much coffee like this, I'm going to need to be going to running to the washroom. Coffee makes me go to the washroom. So today Matthew was actually hiding from the Mukbang video. he is actually not here at all doing funny stuff. Or making noises. Because Matthew still thinks the mukbang videos are weird. I don't know if I'm going to be able to finish this. Oh, the coffee made me full. Can you guys hear this crispy noise from the pizza crust? This dough turns out perfect every time. This dough is actually better than those pre-made crusts that you buy in the big square package with the sauce packets inside. And this dough actually works out to be cheaper than the other packaged pizzas. And so the other day, I bought a bag of salad, and it's still sitting in the fridge, because I thought I'll be craving for salad, but then apparently we wasn't. It's so annoying when that happens. Matthew was being annoying again because I wanted to try to use that new pizza slicer that we got. But Matthew was still the habit and used the knife. So that new pizza slicer that we got, we still haven't used it yet. Ugh. I am stuffed. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed this pizza mukbang with my homemade pizza. Like, you know, the haters are gonna hate. They say, oh, you bought the dough and stuff and it's not homemade, whatever. Whatever. So nice. And so, yeah, the pizza was so good. Like, it's nice to make up your own pizza fillings because you are in control of the ingredients of your pizza. So, I guess I am done for the day. My brain is feeling very fried up today. And so hope you guys are having a lovely Saturday, and hope you guys will have a lovely Mother's Day.